When you include the original flight, we were on the plane for probably 12, 13 hours.
We were on there 15 hours.
20 hours.
28 hours. We were on the plane for over an entire day.
28 hours, over an entire day. There was one aisle in the middle. Everyone knew every inch of that plane.
We were allowed out of our seats, but not off the plane.
You never think about it, but airplane doors are 20 feet in the air.
And even if you survived the jump, they probably would have shot you.
Everyone knew every inch of that plane.
You could go up to first class. You could stretch in the aisles.
Our flight was full. There were children sleeping on the floor.
It had three seats on each side. There was only one aisle in the middle.
We had no way to get information.
This was before most people had mobile phones, and only a couple people got through.
Hello?
Mom?
Bonjour. Operator.
Tom. Oh, thank God. I finally got through. I borrowed a passenger's phone. How are you? Are the kids okay? No, I'm fine, Tom. I'm fine. Safe and sound on the ground here in Newfoundland. We don't know much except for the BBC. Listen, I can't talk long. Can you do something for me?
I'm okay.
I'm fine.
Très bien. Pick up.
Tell the kids I'm all right. Take them into the kitchen and show them the map that we used to put pins in for each destination that we flew together. Tell them I'm fine. Put a pin here in Gander.
On our plane, someone has a mobile phone.
But then the battery dies.
There are phones in the backs of the seats.
But they don't work.
Half the passengers on our plane don't speak English.
Even if we knew what was happening, we don't speak their language.
On our plane, we ask the flight attendants.
But the captain says not to say too much, and that's when rumors start flying.
There's an accident.
An accident?
The U.S. airspace is closed.
For the first time in history.
Why won't she tell us what
happened? A helicopter crashed
into a building.
The White House is bombed!
We need to do something!
Everyone! Oh my God,
it's World War III! Woo!
Meanwhile, on our plane, we didn't have a clue. We were all going insane because
there wasn't squat to do.
Then the captain starts apologizing, says on behalf of the airline, I've given each and every one some
complimentary booze. Open the airplane doors, wave at all the cars. Hello to whoever you are, wherever we are.
The ground crew supplied whatever we needed.
Nicotine patches.
Medication.
Pampers.
Something to drink.
So the flight attendants brought out all the mini bottles of liquor and delivered them to everyone.
Soon everyone got friendlier.
I took a couple of pictures of the view there with my camera. We didn't know where we were,
but we knew that we were hammered. Open the airplane doors. Wave at all the locals. Surely there's something better to do than park wherever we are.
Sitting there for 14 hours when we pull out the Grey Goose.
Kevin and I were kind of hiding it because
we didn't want to share it. Anyway, this woman, this hot mess behind us kept completely freaking out.
Yeah, I don't understand why they can't let us off. I mean, just to stretch our legs. I mean, really, I need to get some air. Oh my God, I need to get off this plane.
And my boyfriend, Kevin, we're both named Kevin. It was cute for a while. Anyway, Kevin was not dealing with it well.
I'm going to kill her.
Excuse me. I would like to get off the plane. I am claustrophobic.
Excuse me. Would you like some Xanax? Because you're freaking out, and it is freaking me out, and we are all freaking the freak out.
Open the airplane doors. Let a little air in here, because I could use a shower or a bar, or a bar. Open the airplane doors. Look at all the planes out there. There must be a convention. It's bizarre. Wherever we are,
28 hours.
28 hours.
Out of the windows.
28
hours. 28 hours.
Out in the darkness.
28 hours.
28 hours.
Darkness and headlines.
28
hours. 28
hours.
Nothing to see.
Hello, it's Bonnie Harris, turn at the Gander SPCA. I went down with the rest of the town to look at all those planes. Yeah, well, I got to wondering if there weren't any animals on them. No. There's no animals on those planes. Not a one. Yeah, oh, okay then, thank you for your time. Oh, Doug, are there animals on those planes?
Probably.
Probably. Are they probably feeding them, then? I'm heading over.
Bonnie, there's armed guards, the army, police everywhere.
Well, then they'll have to shoot me.
Bonnie! Claude,
look at it from my perspective.
Well, you look at it from my perspective.
We've been coming to the table.
Oh, we've been coming to the table, too.
We got the college, the churches, and we got the hotels for the crews, but we need your school buses. We got no effing way to get them there.
Well, why don't you take them in your car?
Yeah, I could fit four in my Corolla. That's a great start.
Great.
You think about it.
Jesus!
2:10 p.m. School bus driver's thinking about leaving the picket lines.
What's the point of an emergency if no one treats it like an effing emergency? And you can quote me on that.
The flight attendants keep telling us nothing's wrong. But I got kids, and I got grandkids. I know when someone's hiding something. And when parents need their kids to stop asking questions, they start playing movies.
We ran through every movie we had. Legally Blonde, Dr. Dolittle 2, and Titanic.
Nothing to do, nothing to see. Thank God we stopped at the duty free. Wherever we are.
Do you mind if I sit here? I need to get some work done, and there's some drunk people at the back of the plane singing at the top of their lungs.
No, of course. I'm Diane.
Nick, how are you doing?
I'm worried about someone. He was flying today. I just wish there was some way to tell him where I am.
Newfoundland. No, you know that. You just can't tell him. Right. I'm hoping you're one of those people who laughs when English people say awkward things.
I just wish we knew what was happening.
What's happening?
Somewhere in between
your life
and your work.
When the world may be falling apart and you think I'm alone.
And I'm so damn helpless. There's nothing left to do but drink.
We open the airplane doors, flash all the cars. Woo! I've never done that before.
28 hours gone, over an entire day. Running out of things to say and wondering if there's someone going to clue us in. Tell us all what's happening, because the sun is setting and we're sitting in the dark wherever we are.
Later that night, I'm up in the cockpit with some of the other passengers when the pilot puts the radio on over the intercom and the whole plane goes silent when the president gives his speech.
I ask the American people to join me in saying a thanks for all the folks who've been fighting hard to rescue our fellow citizens and to join me in saying a prayer for the victims and their families. The resolve of our great nation is being tested. Make no mistake, we will show the world that we will pass this test. God bless.
You got through to the airline, Tom. I'm okay. Tell me what's happening out there. How bad is it? Tell me everything. Tom, who was in the air? No, I wouldn't have known them. No one on that airline. Charles? Are you sure? No. I'm fine, Tom. I'm fine.